My name is Harvansh and thank you for watching my the other videos about the SCCM tutorial. So that video was about to how we can configure our labs and how we can install the SCCM SQL database and others. So let me start this video without wasting the time. So this video is about to what is SCCM. So I got so many feedbacks in my the videos and they are asking like directly I have started videos to install SCCM and their roles, but I have not explained the what is the SCCM. So I came back with this video, what is SCCM. So let me start this video. So what is the SCCM? SCCM is like, it's a System Center Configuration Manager. So full form means System Center Configuration Manager. Now it's a CB and then it's a MEM. So that name is changing continuously, and but I am going to install like a standard what is the SCCM. So SCCM is a Microsoft product. So Microsoft had designed this technology that is called like a SCCM. So it's a Microsoft product. And the next point is SCCM will help you to manage deployment and administrative tasks. So by using the SCCM, we can manage our deployments. Like the deployment, we are gonna do patch activity, application deployment, and the administrative task. And the other thing is like OS deployment and the antivirus management as well. So what is this help? SCCM will help you to manage deployments. So deployment, as I told you, for the patch management, which Microsoft is releasing every second Tuesday, every month of second Tuesday, and that gonna deploy to the end user machine. So SCCM is take caring entire patch activity to make it the compliance for end user machine. Other thing is like the application. Suppose any users needed the Chrome, and Chrome should be deployed for the entire infra. In this case, we can use the SCCM and we can deploy the Chrome in all the machines without interrupting user, and the, all the tasks will done remotely. And the administrative task, like the other thing is application management and tracking there, how much user is using, and it gonna help us for reducing the license cost. So like any user, suppose any user we deployed license application to user, and that user is not using frequently that application, or user is not at all using that application, so unnecessary we are paying that cost. So that we can monitor it and we can remove it from where it's not required. And the administrative task is something like a, we're gonna do it remotely, something on the machines. So that is a, that comes under the administrative task. So here is other thing is SCCM allow user to manage a large number of computer remotely. So SCCM, by using the SCCM, you can manage large number of computer that remotely. You can do anything that remotely, like the patch deployment, application deployment, there the metering, monitoring, and the other things as well. So that was the like a introduction about the SCCM. Like what is the SCCM and why we have to learn it. So let's move it to the next slide. So why to use the SCCM? So first I explain what is SCCM, and now it is like a why to use the SCCM. So why we need it, even though like we are installing the patch that we can deploy it manually, and application we are deploying that we can, that also we can do the manually, but why we need the, again the SCCM. So SCCM is using to increase IT productivity. So in IT, productivity is the main concern when we are working in a IT. So if we are manually deploying the applications, so our productivity very very low, and we need the manpower, huge manpower actually. So IT product to increase the IT productivity and the efficiency by reducing the manual task. As I told, if we are deploying any application, then the manual task will reduce if we are using SCCM. and letting you the focus on the high value project. So in this, if we are using like multiple packages are in the queue, which is necessary to deploy it, so we can deploy in the sequence by sequence, so we can focus on the high valuable project, and then it's increase overall productivity. So finally, the productivity is the main concern in IT. So it will increase the productivity by providing the right software at the right time. Suppose any user is want any software, immediately it should be installed on that machine. If we are gonna deploy it the manually, it will take much time and human error could be there, and there could be the risk whether the right software is installed to him or not. So here, increase overall productivity. So till now we talk about the productivity, how it gonna increase. So very less number of manpower can use in SCCM and can deliver the high amount of work. And the by providing the risk right software to the right time, to whenever user want, we can make it the available application on their system. So that's why we are using the SCCM. And the next is SCCM IT service features for the delivery. Okay, so let's understand what we are talking here. Secure and scalable deployment of application software update and the operating system endpoint protection. So when we are deploying any application software's update and the operating system and the endpoint protection, it's a antivirus, so it will be a very secure, and we can deploy in a secure way or right time we can deliver, and it's a scalable. Okay, so whenever the main concern is for the manpower and the right time, right software should be delivered. Okay, so by using this, when we deployed any application patch, it will be a more secure compared to other, like a manually we are using or other things we are using, like the GPO we can use it, and there is a other tool as well. Okay, so next point is real-time action on the device management. So how does it work, the real-time management? So real-time action, we can take it on the machine. Like suppose we need to check the any what is the uptime, machine uptime, hard disk disk size, and we're gonna reboot that machine. So any real-time actions we can use by using the SCCM. And the other thing, cloud power analysis and the management for on-premises and the internet-based devices. So that features also we can use in the in SCCM to cloud power analysis and the management on-premises. So we can use the these features as well, like to, we can manage the our cloud and cloud machines through SCCM, and the manage for on premises. So whichever is the servers or the laptop, desktop, on premises devices, we can manage by the SCCM. And the other thing is the internet based devices. So internet based devices is something like when the user are not having any kind of connectivity to their company. I can give you the example, like we are using a VPN to connect the company infra, and when the user is not having the VPN access and there is a no way to connect the company infra, that means it comes totally out of the DMZ zone. So in this scenario, how the user will get application and the patch deployment? So in this part, we can SCCM provide the facility for the internet based devices. So if user connect the internet, he can receive the application and he can receive the patches over the cloud. So by enabling this internet based devices, we can manage the internet based device management. Okay, so compliance setting management. So this is what something like compliance. So when we are talking the compliance, it's up to company, like how they define their compliance settings. Like like we have a 10,000 machines and company told me to patch all the machines or install the applications. So easily we can deploy the patch or application, and we can get the reports. It's very easy to get the report in SCCM for the tracking purpose, how many machines are installed, suppose a application I'm gonna deploy it, and what is the compliance for it, and how much is the remaining, and what is the issue going on the machine. So that's kind of things we can manage it. And compliance word is not only for the patch or application, there is a certain parameters are there, just like giving you an example. Okay, so other thing is the compressive management for the device, laptop, and the VDIs, laptop, desktop, the VDI. So we can manage these. So here is compressive management for server, desktop, and the laptop VDIs. So what we gonna do with this? So we can manage their servers, laptop, desktop in the wide area. Wide area in the sense is like, as I told you, the SCCM main concentration to deliver patch deployment, application, and the operating system. So in that other part also we can use it as a like a wide area, like the application monitoring, what the application are used by users, and there the license, their inventories, and we can measure like which application where is installed, which machine is not rebooted, or these many days, what the hard disk full, and like the there the hardware part as well, like which hard disk they are using, how much the size, total size, how many drives is there, how much is full, and the other thing is how many RAMs are running there, utilization for that machine. So it's kind of a complete management for server, desktop, and the server, laptop, desktop, and the VDI. So we can manage totally for that. Okay guys, so let me move it to the next slide, is like configuration manager, extend and integrate this. So when we are starting to learn SCCM, we should know what other things are gonna merge with the SCCM. So SCCM is a big technology which is not going to use only the one. So SCCM is integrate with the some other technology as well. So we need at least the basic things about the other technology as well if we wanna learn the SCCM. So by learning only the SCCM, learning is waste of time, but if we can expand our learning things and learning the site technology which is merged with the SCCM and they are supporting to deliver their task, so it will be like a very good. So then we can be like a, okay, now we completely understanding the SCCM. So just only the deploying the patch or deploying the patches, running the report, so that is not gonna help. And the other things, what the other technology merge with the semantic manager, we can say we are using other technology as well inside the SCCM, so we should know that feature as well. So that's why I have mentioned configuration manager extend and integrates with the below things. Okay, so SCCM manager, he extend there the support, can say, or the area, and integrate with the other features, other application. They are the independent applications, and but we are using in the SCCM. Okay, so let us understand what we are using extra apart from SCCM, and what we need to learn the other technology. It's just for the basic level, you need to understand just the basic or L1 level for the other technology, so you will be something in a good shape to work in SCCM and deliver some task. Okay guys, so let's see this point. What we're gonna explain here, Microsoft Intune co-management a wide variety of the mobile device. So when we are talking about the Intune and the co-management to manage the application device, so we are not going to learn completely Microsoft Intune, just we're gonna learn the basic things how we can manage our mobile devices. If we have a plan to manage our mobile devices with the SCCM, obviously we need to know the concept of Microsoft Intune to co-management Okay, so at least we need some idea and understand how this Microsoft Intune is working. So it's very important to deliver the mobile device platform. Second thing is Microsoft Azure to host a cloud service, extend your the management services. Okay, so if we are going to use something like a cloud DP and the other things is which is gonna deliver through the cloud, so we need to understand the Microsoft Azure concept. So Microsoft Azure to host the cloud services. So if we are hosting any services in the cloud and we integrate with the SCCM, which is something like in our end user machine, we're gonna use directly internet and directly we are not connecting with the company. So that is the data is coming from the cloud. So we need to understand the basic things about the Microsoft Azure. And just guys, I'm taking it's a very light way and no need to upgrade. Like for the learning SCCM, we need so many technology. No, just a basic. And if you learn this thing, like you should be like a L2 or L3 level. Just working for L1, L2 level, these are not at all required. So just I'm giving you the brief of what are the things integrated with SCCM. Okay, so second thing is the Windows Server Update Services, WSS, to manage software. So through SCCM, we are deploying patches to end user machine. But SCCM itself is not downloading any patch from Microsoft side. He need a one more tool, WSS. First, we need to install the WSS. WSS will connect with the Microsoft side. It will get the patches, metadata it will get it, and when we enable the software update point role, then WSS and the SCCM will integrate, then WSS will give all the patches to SCCM. So we need to understand the basic of WSS also, how it is working. Anyway, WSS is not a very big technology, it's a very small tool. Earlier it was using standalone and now it merged with the SCCM. Now next thing is a certificate services. So certificate services also, it's a very wide technology, and so again, that is a no need to understand in depth. Just we need to understand the basic things, like when the client is communicating with the SCCM, obviously there will be the certificate required. So we need to understand the certificate little bit concept, like how we're gonna check the license and the start date when it license will gonna expire. So these many things, at least for the checklist purpose, we can inform to the management, okay, the license part is gonna expire and it will taken care by the other team. So at least we need the basic knowledge to understand if my the certificate expires, so at least I can check it. Okay, so next thing is a very important, Microsoft SQL database server. So without SQL database server, SCCM is not at all possible to install in server. SCCM need a database that we can use the Microsoft SQL, even we can use the other SQL as well, but both the product are from the Microsoft, so compatibility will be good if you are using Microsoft SQL database server. So the connection will not be through any error, and we can work easily. So we need the SQL database server, and again we need the basic knowledge about the SQL server. So if you learn it more into that, then it will be a good. So you can create a customized report. If you know well SQL, you can fetch the data from SQL, like the patch compliance, application deployment. So it will be good. Even though if you are something expert, then you can create a dashboard as well. So it's gonna very much helpful for your job. Okay, so let me go to the next slide. It is the Exchange server and the online. So why I am talking here the Exchange? So it is not required too much depth knowledge. Just you need to understand the what is the Exchange server and the Exchange online. So Exchange server, where it required in SCCM to sending the automatic email. like in SCCM, if we put you knows that exchange is using to sending the email. So if any automated email is going on or any kind of email one place to another place is sending, exchange will be in between. So we need to understand little bit about the exchange server as well. Okay, so now why exchange is required? Okay, so we have in SCCM reports, and if we don't want to run it again and again, so we would like to schedule it, then we can get on our email that complete report. So it should be subscribed. We are calling in SCCM subscribe. If we subscribe that report, it will run that report automatically and it will send it to your email. To sending the email, we need the exchange server. Okay, so now it is a next point is a group policy. Yes, we need a group policy basic also, to set up the SCCM infra. Group policy knowledge is must, because we gonna deploy a GPO to entire machines to opening the firewall ports. So it's not easy to open firewall port which is required to communication like client to SCCM server, and that should be open from end user to server machine. Okay, to server, and that port if we manually we are opening, it's very tough. Better to create a GPO and deploy, so it will override the local GPO and your port will be open. And there are the other things also required, like the WMI should be working, and the other things also we can put it, like in GPO we can put the WSH path also. So if you don't know the GPO, that it will be little tough to run your infra. But if we already infra is built and you are working in a existing infra, so it's not gonna tough to you, because already infra is done, and maybe your GPO also will be done by who built your infra. So it's not like a compulsory these things, but you could have understand it, it would be better to you. So first you learn this thing, these SCCM, what is the SCCM, how it gonna use, and how we gonna deploy patch application, then you go for this slides. Then other thing is the DNS. So DNS also one of the part for SCCM, because one machine, end user machine, will connect with SCCM server. And if you are not understanding the DNS concept, if suppose one machine is disconnected from network or is not communicating, or there is any issue and you don't know the DNS concept, so it will be a little tough to do troubleshooting, and again you will be pulling or involving the other guys. So better to learn that basic of the DNS concept. So basically DNS is using to resolve that host name, like we are pinging one machine to SCCM, and just we are checking whether the connectivity is there, it's resolving the DNS or not. So that thing and the other part also involved from the DNS. And there is a one more thing is the DHCP. So DHCP, why we are using DHCP? By the DHCP we are getting a IP, and this part is going to use in your OSD purpose. So mainly the OSD purpose, other things you can manage easily, because a DNS already will be there. And when you are gonna use your OSD part, and you need a IP from DHCP, then it's a compulsory to understand the DHCP concept, because when your OS is not there and you need some IP to deploy your OS, and in that case your DHCP will come to the picture and it will help in that. So all the things immediately no need to learn, just first you understand the SCCM. Just I'm telling so you guys will be remember. Okay, so this is our the next explorer. Second thing is a Windows automated deployment kit, that called the Windows ADK and the user state migration USMT. Okay guys, so this features also must be used for the OSD purpose, and where we'll get the WinPE and the user state migration tool, so that is gonna help to migrate something in the SCCM, like we are migrating SCCM 7 to 12 and the other migration. So both the technology are very vast, like the ADK and the user state migration. So you just need to know the basic things, how these technologies are working. Other thing is a remote and the remote assistant. So you need to understand like remote desktop and the remote assistant, how it's working, and SCCM having the features to for the remote desktop and the remote assistant as well, to check any things on that remote machine. So you need to just understand about these concepts. Okay guys, so let me go to the another slide. And here is a finally SCCM features. So what are the features are available currently in the SCCM? I'm mentioning like a SCCM, but few people will raise like a concern, now we are in SCCM CB and we are in MEM. So just I'm explaining you the standard. So if you write the SCCM CB or MEM, the most of the features, 90% feature will be the same. And maybe I missed out something, any points, because I have created this PPTs myself, and it's my understanding level. I put it here to make you guys understand. So here is what the SCCM can do it. So it's kind of a capacity of my SCCM. So that can application management. So SCCM will do the application management. When we are talking something the management, then it's completely inside there, like application we deploy it, and after that where it's got failed, where it's success, that complete report, their troubleshooting, and make it the compliance what your company needed, that called completely like a application management. Like completely we are managing that starting to end. Like we deploy application, compliance came, machine failed, or it's not reach, or there is a so many troubleshooting, and we get that report, then we again we start troubleshooting, after that finally we make it the compliance. So entire thing called like a application management. In the same way we can manage like the software updates. So again it's the same story, like patch we download it and deploy to end user. And so this is not my job done, then we need to monitor, okay, how many patches got installed, where it got failed, where it's failed, I have to troubleshoot and make it the compliance. So these entire process called like a software update management. Then it's come to operating system deployment. Okay, so our company nowadays, you notice that in our laptop we don't have the writer option, CD DVD writer, which we are using CD and DVD. So now directly we are having the LAN cable. So through LAN cable only we can deploy the operating system. So entire operating system deployment is managed by the SCCM. It can be like your OS, then applications, drivers, and all those things. I mean to say, from bare metal machines in the sense is where machine is not having OS, from to that level that user can easily work. Means I install OS, driver I install, application I install, and I add it into the domain, and everything is working fine and machine is ready to use. That comes under the operating system deployment. Now again is the one more feature is the endpoint protection. So in SCCM we can use it our antivirus features as well. So antivirus feature is like few of you knows, or all you knows, like we need the SCCM when we are working in IIT. So it could be a Symantec antivirus, it could be a Trend Micro, it could be a McAfee, but we have the antivirus, sure, or else the virus infection happen and the everything will be gone. So to protect it we are using the antivirus, and Microsoft came up with the plan to introduce the antivirus feature as well. So here is so many people are using that antivirus features, so you can try that. And as I came to know, current I don't know whether Microsoft is charging something or not, but earlier it was not charging anything to use the endpoint protection feature. Okay, Okay guys, so like the next feature is the co-management. So this is again something related to your cloud, where we are gonna manage like a co-management where the SCCM client will be there, and we can manage the machines through the cloud as well. So that called like a co-management. So we can do the co-management in our SCCM and the desktop analysis. So desktop analysis, it is what is that? We're gonna analyze our the desktop. So kind of thing, laptop, desktop, and tablet. It's in the sense is completely we have hold on that machine in terms of any deployment. Okay, this is the one part. Second part for the inventory. Inventory, I'm talking like all the details related to that. Laptop, desktop, and tablet, like how many software are installed, it's come under the software inventory. What are the hardware related? Comes like a what is the hard disk you are using, how much free and full, and what is the using. Next thing is like we can use it for the license purposing, where the application is installed but user are not using. So we can analyze all the things by using the SCCM. So that is comes like a, in a reporting part. Now the other feature is like a cloud attached management. So when we are managing our machine through the cloud, and that comes under like a cloud management. So you can integrate your SCCM with the cloud, that it comes under like similar like co-management, and you can manage your end user machine. So it's something like a where we are not using the VPN, but we're gonna manage our the machine through the cloud, so that you can use it. And the other feature is like a real-time management. So as I explained you in the my last PPT, real-time management, like we're gonna check what is the uptime, when it got rebooted, when it got log off, and and other part is like we want to reboot that machine immediately, so we can trigger a alert and to user like your machine is gonna reboot in 10 minutes, 15 minutes, 1 hour, it's up to you. And other thing, what the applications are used by the user, and which application frequently are not using user, and like the what kind of application is installed. So we can use all the real times what we are gonna use a check manually, that things we can check through the SCCM as a real time. And the company resource access. So company resource access is something like we can manage the company resources and their the access through the SCCM. So SCCM, if I am an administrator and we gonna manage the company resources, so obviously I should have a access with my service account, and easily I can manage their resources access as well. But it is something part like a AD, but more things you can't do it, but yeah, somehow you can do it. Compliance management. So as I told you, a compliance management is something like a for the application management, application deployment, and so we deploy one application and we need that their compliance, then only we can manage our the compliance part. So in SCCM easily we can get report. It's a very familiar with the all reports, like which machine is installed, if we deploy any application, so in which machine is installed, we can get that machine host name, we can get the overall compliance, get it called failed, we can get the host name and the overall failed percentage, how many machines are rebooting. So that's kind of things we can use it in manage easily. That comes under the compliance management. And the other thing is the inventory management. So we can manage the inventory as well. As I explained you in my last PPT, inventory management is three types of the inventory. Hardware inventory, so it comes about overall hardware, like which laptop you are using, which company it is, and what is the model of that laptop, how many hard disk is available, how much hard disk is free, how much RAM you are using, how much size in the RAM. So these comes related to hardware, it's come under the hardware inventory.
and the software inventories, like something which patch is installed in your machine, which application is installed in your machine, to get the details, to get that inventory, we can use it software inventory. So these all three comes under the inventory management. Asset intelligence is something like where we gonna manage license kind of things. So or we gonna monitor any application. Like I want to just see that in one user how long this Chrome application he is using in a day, how many hours he is using, or how many hours he's using the other applications, like Acrobat Reader is a license application. If we deploy to all user and 30-40% user are not using that, that means is a waste of license cost. So we can track that through the asset intelligence, and we can remove that application, license application, from that user. So we can provide a license application to needed user who required this application. So in this part, we can manage through the asset intelligence. So guys, this was the overview of the SCCM, and after this video, I'm gonna start step by step what is the SCCM, like the collection, user collection, and the other things. So if you like my videos, keep watching, continue. I'm gonna explain each and every part about the SCCM. So thank you guys for watching this video. See you soon in my next video.